In this tutorial, you will learn how you can use OpenRouter to add hundreds of large language models directly into make.com, which I think is definitely the easiest way to add artificial intelligence to your scenarios. So OpenRouter is basically a really cool service that lets you access all these large language models without having to create an account at, for example, OpenAI, and an account at DeepSeek, and an account at Meta. You can just directly in OpenRouter access all these models. You can also see a list of all of them over here. I think it's like 200-300 models at the moment. And like I said, you can, for example, access the one from OpenAI or Meta, or the one from Google or DeepSeek. You can access them all directly in here. And what is also really cool is that there's also plenty of free large language models that you can use. And usually the only difference is that they are a little bit slower, which for most things in make.com does not matter so much anyway. So definitely worth checking out. So you can integrate OpenRouter directly into your scenarios with a module like this to create a chat completion. And then you can select the model that you want to use and then the prompt that you want to complete. So let me show you step by step how you can integrate that, and then I'll show you two cool examples so that you can just get started with this right away. So the first thing you want to do after creating a free account is to head over to the credits page and add a few bucks so that you can use the premium large language models. If you only want to use the free models, then that's not necessary, but if you want to use the premium ones, you need a few bucks in there. And it's maybe also good to know that OpenRouter is basically free to use. There is no subscription model or anything. You only pay 5%. You can see that over here, to add the credits to your account, and then you can just use the language models for the regular price. Now then, after you've done that, you want to go over to the API keys and you want to create a new key. Now, and then for example, call this one make, so that you know that it is for make.com, and click create. So this gives you your key over here. This is basically like a password, so do not share it with anyone. And then go over to a new scenario and look for OpenRouter, create a chat completion. Now then the first thing we want to do is we want to add a connection. So give it a name and paste the API key in there, click save. And then if it was successful, then you will see this window over here. Now then the first thing I like to do is to select a model. So in this case, I just want to test and play around. So I will use the free DeepSeek model. Maybe by the time that you watch this video, the model already has a different name, but just look for DeepSeek free or free and any other kind of language model. But I will use this one over here and enable automatic fallback. I will leave that to yes. And that's actually really cool. That means that if something goes wrong with DeepSeek or with their language model, then it will automatically pick another one that does something similar for a similar cost. Now, then we want to message the language model. So then the first thing you want to do is you want to go over the role system and we want to tell it what its purpose is, what it's doing. So I'm going to say here, you are a funny assistant. And then we want to message it. So role user, and I'm just going to say, hello there. And I'm going to click save. Click save again. And then we're going to click run once to test it out. Then you see it sent it, and then we're going to wait for the chat completion, which we got under output, choices, one, message, and then here, content. This is always going to be your chat completion. So in this case, it says, wearing a clown nose, hello back at you, you glorious human being. Did you know I was just practicing my stand-up comedian routine about binary code? Spoiler, it has two chokes. Ha ha ha. Okay, so it did its job, right? Like we said, hey, you are a funny assistant, and we just said hello there. We did not ask it anything to do. So pretty cool. Now then, if you want to take this to the next level, instead of having an automatic fallback, you can also use another module here, create a completion with fallback. And what that allows you to do is it allows you to set the models it's going to use, including the fallbacks. So it's quite cool. For example, what I like to do here is to use maybe a free language model like this one from DeepSeek. And then this one is the free model of them. And basically the only difference is that it's a little bit slower and it might have more outages. So what you want to do is you want to create some kind of backup. Now I added $5 to my account. So what I can just do is I can just search here for DeepSeek. And then over here we have the paid model. So what we do now is we use their free model. And if some case something goes wrong, then we use the paid model. And if you want, you can even add another one. You could, for example, say here, okay, if something goes wrong with DeepSeek, then we want to use this model from OpenAI. Now, and then over here, you would do the same thing again. So you would set a system, you would say here, you are a funny assistant. And then over here, role user, we just say, hello there. Click save again. And then over here, I'm gonna click run this module only. And then you see over here also always which model it used. So that's also quite useful then if you have that. And then under choices, message, content, it says again, here are chat completion. Now let me show you two cool ways of how you could use this just to get your brains flowing of what is possible in Maker.com, because this is really cool. So the first one over here, I connected to ActiveCampaign, which is my email service provider. And this scenario starts whenever there is a new lead. And then what I wanted to do is I wanted to scrape the homepage of that person. So I get the domain name out of their email address. I visit that page. I use make.com to download that page. Then I send this to OpenRouter, or a language model in OpenRouter, in this case, DeepSeek. And then I update a custom field in ActiveCampaign. Let me quickly demonstrate how that works. So over here you see we have a new lead, Sam Doe at automatedwithmax.com. It's my own website, but it's just an example, right, to see how it works. And then you see over here that I used this formula to get the domain name out of the email address and then visited this page over here. Then this is the data that we downloaded, which is the whole page, including everything. And then we send that over to OpenRouter. And then this is what we got back over here, content. Automate with Max teaches you how to use make.com to automate tasks and save time in online businesses. So it's correct, right? Now, and then we update the custom field inside ActiveCampaign here under business summary. And then what is really cool, I can then use that to personalize my marketing emails even further with AI. Super cool. Now then the second example is this over here where I generate a Facebook post with a language model in OpenRouter. So this RSS module is looking for the YouTube feed. And in this case, it is looking for my YouTube channel so that whenever a new video is posted, this is going to start at these days at 9 o'clock in the evening. And then in OpenRouter here, I said, you are a professional copywriter for social media and you write one short Facebook post based on a new video that I will provide the details of. Now, and then here, a bunch more rules that you can read if you like. And then here in the user role, I said, here are the new video details. The title is this and the description is this, which I both got from the RSS module. And then you see over here that I did our trick from earlier. So I use the free model, and if the free model somehow is not available, then I use the paid model. Now, and then I use that to post it to Facebook. So let me demonstrate. So over here, we have a new video. New video is called Build Scenarios Faster in Make.com. Then over here, I send it and I got back, just dropped a new video showing how to build scenarios faster in Make.com. No more getting stuck in your setup phase. Super cool, right? And then I posted this to Facebook with a link to the new video for people to watch. So yeah, this is how you use OpenRouter in Maker.com to access hundreds of large language models. If you have any questions about this, just let me know in the comments below.